I'm so tired of 9 to 5, weighing down on my soul. Let's get out on this uptown life, head out on the country road. Forget about all the things that we can make right. Put on a little Emmy Lou and we'll dance into the night. Hold my loving arms. My loving arms are for you. Hold my loving arms. My loving arms are for you. All we need is time, honey. All we need is time. Sit on the front porch, kick off your shoes. We don't need nowhere to go, we don't need a tune. In a world that gets lost in making plans, just be my woman, yeah, and I'll be a man. Hold my loving arms, my loving arms are for you. Hold loving arms, my loving arms are for you. Oh, my loving arms, my loving arms are for you. Say you hold my loving arms, my loving arms are for you. Won't you hold my loving arms are for you. My loving arms, my loving arms are for you. Oh, my loving arms, my loving arms for you. Oh, my loving arms, my loving arms are for you. Oh, my loving arms, my loving arms for you. Day and every day, and marry me if I ever get the nerve to say hello in this cafe. Say you will, say you will. always be, always be happy by my side. Promise you, sing to you all music that I
write. Aloha mai kākou. We'll try that again. You just have to say aloha. Aloha mai kākou.
Aloha.
Welcome and good afternoon. Our couple, Matt and Kat, Matthew, Catherine, thank you as family and friends for what you've shared together in the past, the support, the experiences, the friendships. They are honored that you are all here today to share in their wedding celebration and ask that you all continue to be an important part of their lives. We are aware that there is a cloud of witnesses who are present, who are not present with us in the physical realm, but we are assured that they are here with us in spirit and join us on this special occasion. The following Olelo No'iau, or Hawaiian proverb, is appropriate as we congregate here at this amazing venue here in Luana Hills. Mehelau no ke ko'olau ake aloha, which means love is like the fingertips of the ko'olau breeze, gentle, invisible, but present nevertheless. We are to celebrate a new passage in the lives of Matt and Kat. We are gathered to witness Matt and Kat's commitment to each other, the commitment which will make them husband and wife. With this commitment, we are bringing together two people today. We are bringing together two families and two perspectives. And this blending of family and perspective enriches both Matt and Kat and helps enrich our world. E kolu mea nui mā kāho nua, a kamana o i'o, a kamana o lana, a me ke aloha ka oiae. Paul said in 1 Corinthians that there are three great things on this earth, faith, hope, and love, but the greatest of these is love. We are aware that love is one of life's most fulfilling experiences. At its best, it reduces our selfishness, deepens our personalities, and makes our lives complete. Love, as it exists in marriage, is beyond the excitement of romantic, affectionate love, but it is neither devoid of affection nor romance. Real love is a friendship that is deepened. It is a quiet understanding, a mutual trust, and a striving for common goals. Real love is about sharing the small pleasures of everyday living, and it is companionship when confronted with life's challenges. In a deep and abiding love, it is clearly understood that a joy shared is twice the joy, and a sorrow shared is half the sorrow. Matt and Kat, this commitment which you are making today is not at the expense of your individuality. Rather, the uniqueness of each of you is enhanced by this strength of this union. And I know you are very well aware of this fact, for you've expressed it in your letters to each other. When I was asked to be the celebrant for this special occasion, I told Matt and Kat the requirement that I have for my wedding couples, and that is that they write a letter to each other, a statement of their feelings and intentions, and I have their permission to share these letters with you. Have you guys shared them with each other? They have not yet shared them with each other. Only me. So you can face each other. Matt, you have stated that the first thing that drew you to Kat was her genuine warmth. From the moment you met her, you had a sense that you can only describe as being in the company of someone truly great. Through the years, you have come to learn that these initial feelings were not only proven correct, but she has one of the biggest hearts you have ever come to know. Kat's selflessness, integrity, and love for others make her an incredibly cherished friend, co-worker, sister, and daughter to all who know and love her. For these qualities, along with her numerous talents, you have grown to love and appreciate Kat with all of your being. Kat alone has your heart and your complete and unyielding trust. Today you choose Catherine. You commit to a tradition of living and expressing your love. You commit to your future and your families. You commit to a lifetime of working together towards your common goals. And above all, you commit to your journey. You can't imagine a better partner to voyage with. You commit to making Kat laugh every damn day. That's what he wrote that. I didn't put that in. Life will test your limits. There will be times in which you may want to call it quits, but you won't quit. You will fight. You will fight for Kat from this day to your last, like your parents and grandparents have done before you. And you wanted to say, Kat, that you choose her not only today, but you choose her every day for the rest of your lives. Matt, are these statements a correct expression of your feelings and intentions as you present yourself to be Kat's husband?
Yes, they are.
Kat, you've stated that being with Matt is the best part of your day. From the moment you met, his genuine smile and kind heart made you feel like you had known Matt forever. Whether you are feeling your best or your worst, Matt's kindness and support are ever present. Matt makes you laugh every day, and she didn't say every damn day. And he brings out the best in you and everyone around you. Your family and friends were instantly at ease when they met Matt. And 3 weeks after you met, the time suddenly came for your parents to move to North Carolina. Without a second thought, Matt showed up to your house with a truck, helped you load your belongings, and relocated them to a small studio apartment in Manoa. Let it be known that this was on a Sunday after Matt had worked a long, grueling 6-day week in the heat. At that moment, you remember your parents looking at each other with an expression that read, "Catherine is in good hands." Since then, Matt has done nothing but prove this to be true. The list goes on and on. That story speaks of Matt's work ethic and the fact that he goes above and beyond to help his family and loved ones. This is one of the things you love most about Matt. His family would do the same, and you are honored to be a part of the Culver tribe. Knowing Matt has been a great adventure. He's been at the finish line of every race you've done. He's helped you brainstorm, problem solve, and accomplish some amazing things in the past 3.5 years. And these past few months in particular have put your teamwork to the test, and you couldn't feel more confident that Matt is the right one to have by your side. While you can't promise that every day will be perfect or easy, you can promise Matt everlasting devotion, love, and respect. You promise to listen to Matt, dream with him, build with him, protect and encourage him through all of life's opportunities and challenges. As you grow in your love and marriage and through all that you encounter, you promise to be someone Matt admires and respects. Matt is the love of your life, and you will be his hub and devoted partner for a lifetime. Kat, are these statements a correct expression of your feelings and intentions as you present yourself to be Matt's wife?
Yes.
Will Matt and Kat's parents please stand? At this time, Matt and Kat would like to honor their parents with a presentation of lay. Thank you. who has the honor of presenting Matt to be married here today?
We do.
Matt and Kat want to thank you for the love that has informed their own love, and they earnestly seek your blessing upon their marriage today. And so I ask you, will you, as their parents, joyfully offer your blessings to their union, and will you pledge to nurture Matt and Kat in this new relationship to the best of your abilities? If so, please say, we will.
We will.
You may be seated. Matthew and Catherine, today you are making an important commitment to each other. The essence of this commitment is in accepting each other completely. Marriage is therefore a decision which is not to be entered into lightly, but rather undertaken with great respect, reverence, consideration, and joy. Matthew and Catherine would like to express their commitment by the sharing of their vows before this community of family and friends. Right palm down, left palm up. Well done. Right palm left up. Good. I, Matthew,
take you, Catherine,
to be my wife. I will love you, honor you, and be with you.
I will love you, honor you, and be with you.
In joy and in sorrow.
In joy and in sorrow.
In plenty and in want.
In plenty and in want.
In health and in sickness.
In health and in sickness.
All the days of my life.
All the days of my life.
You can look at him. I, Catherine.
Take you, Matthew.
To be my husband.
To be my husband.
I will love you, honor you, and be with you.
I will love you, honor you, and be with you.
In joy and in sorrow.
In joy and in sorrow.
In plenty and in want.
In plenty and in want.
In health and in sickness.
In health and in sickness.
All the days of my life.
All the days of my life.
Left hand to left hand. Read.
Can I take that?
Yeah, that'd be helpful. These rings are symbols of the vows you've just expressed. The complete circle of these rings represents Matthew and Catherine's never-ending love and complete acceptance of each other. May these rings always be reminders of the promises you have made to each other. And may God's blessing be upon these rings, just as you are a blessing to each other. A little one. Yeah. Catherine, I give you this ring.
Catherine, I give you this ring.
As a symbol that I will love and honor you.
As a symbol that I will love and honor you.
With all that I am.
With all that I am.
All that I have.
All that I have.
Now and forever.
Now and forever.
Shove it.
It's good now.
It's a bit there. Matthew, I give you this ring.
Matthew, I give you this ring.
As a symbol that I will love and honor you.
As a symbol that I will love and honor you.
With all that I am.
With all that I am.
All that I have.
All that I have.
Now and forever.
Now and forever.
Okay, you can turn and face me. You can hold hands if you want. As two people committed to each other, I charge you, Matthew and Catherine, to pace yourselves in life so that you save time for each other. And when your togetherness is not particularly loving, I want you to patiently work toward returning to your loving relationship. When times get tough, as you know they will, I hope you will recall this bit of wisdom. May you never forget what is worth remembering, and never remember what is best forgotten. When decisions and challenges arise in your lives, I charge you to work to maintain a stable, loving relationship by sharing your concerns sincerely and honestly with each other. Be sensitive and understanding in your togetherness, knowing that no matter how well we know someone, we can't always read their hearts and minds. I charge you both to grow with each other and because of each other, to keep a capacity for wonder, for spontaneity, for humor. I charge you to remain warm, affectionate, and nurturing with each other. I charge you both to be tender and appreciative toward each other to be keenly aware of your relationship and to continually work to help it grow and become ever more loving. You can face out and make room for me. You can hold the other hands. Yeah. So we know it takes a lot of courage to make the commitment that Matt and Kat are making here today. Marriage not only requires a lot of work on the part of the couple, but their community of family and friends is very influential. It can help or hinder their relationship. Matt and Kat's vows have been shared, and now I ask you as a community of their family and friends to support and encourage the growth of their relationship. If you promise to support and encourage the growth of Matthew and Catherine's relationship, please powerfully proclaim, "We do."
We do.
Yeah, well done. Turn and face me. Let us pray. As we pause within the quiet radiance of this moment, dear gracious, loving, and ever-present God, we ask for your blessing upon the love we have celebrated here with Matthew and Catherine. Grant them all those qualities of mind and spirit that build relationships of happiness and harmony. Be with them during all the moments of their lives that the beauty of this moment may endure forever. We also ask that you grant that all couples who have witnessed this expression of love may, in their hearts and spirits, renew their wedding vows and discover new and exciting ways for the continued growth of their love. Thus may we all feel our lives uplifted by the miraculous adventure of a love that is shared and passed along. Amen. We've witnessed, it's only 14 more pages. Witnessed a beautiful moment this afternoon. Matt and Kat have accepted vows that bind them together by the giving and receiving of rings. They have pledged themselves to each other. They have celebrated who they are and what they mean to each other and the possibilities that lie before them. And because your commitment is deep and your celebration sincere, on behalf of all those present, I acknowledge that you are husband and wife. And your kiss will seal the commitment you have made here today. O mai ka'i na mea apau, and all things are blessed.
Step, every moment I'm looking for.
And all I am, all I have, all I have is yours. And you watch my heart beg a little bit more. My heart beg a little bit more.